तो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, अब अपने नेक्स्ट वीडियो को लेके मैं फिर आपके सामने हूँ। पिछले वीडियो में हमने देखा था कि रिलेशन को इक्विवेलेंस रिलेशन कैसे प्रूव करते हैं। अब इस वीडियो में दो एग्जांपल मैं ले रहा हूँ आपके एनसीईआरटी टेक्स्ट बुक के फर्स्ट एक्सरसाइज के दो क्वेश्चन है। वो जो एग्जाम जो क्वेश्चन ऐसे है कि जो इक्विवेलेंस रिलेशन नहीं है, हम ये कैसे बताएंगे कि ये रिलेशन इक्विवेलेंस है या नहीं है, वो चेक करना है। तो इक्विवेलेंस रिलेशन है वो पिछले वीडियो में एक हमने क्वेश्चन देखा था। इसमें पहला हमारा क्वेश्चन है, चेक वेदर रिलेशन आर ऑन आर, दिस इज रिलेशन एंड दिस इज फॉर रियल नंबर्स, डिफाइंड एज रिलेशन आर इक्वल टू ए बी सच दैट ए लेस देन इक्वल टू बी इज इक्विवेलेंस। रिलेशन अपना वो है कि जिसमें हम वो ऑर्डर्ड पेयर लिखेंगे जो इस कंडीशन को सेटिस्फाई कर रहा है। ordered pairs satisfying this condition a less than equal to b. We know that every number satisfies this condition, so we can write directly a belongs to r as every number is either less than or equal to itself as a equal to a. So r is reflexive. Let A B belongs to R. It implies that A is less than or equal to B. But B is not less than or equal to A. We know that whenever a number is less than or equal to B, then the other number is not less than A. It means BA does not belong to R. AB is there but BA is not there. It implies that R is not symmetric. अच्छा, जहां भी ये बात आ जाए कि ये symmetric नहीं है, वहां हमें एक example देना। Example 1, 2 belongs to R as 1 is less than equal to 2, but 2, 1 does not belong to R. So the relation is not symmetric. तो जहां भी अगर नहीं की बात है तो हमें एक example देना है, और जो universal बात है वहां कोई example देने की जरूरत नहीं है। क्यों? हम जानते हैं कि A equal to A for every real number is equal to itself. तो यहां कोई example देने की जरूरत नहीं है, इससे पता लगा हमें कि R reflexive है। A is less than B, but B is not less than A, maybe equal to, but we have to consider all the cases. Not only 1, 1 belongs to R, then we say that 1, 1 again belongs to R. No, when 1, 2 is there, 2, 1 is not there. One example is sufficient. Now for third case, let A B belongs to R. हमारा relation क्या कहता है? A B belongs to R means A is less than equal to B. Implies that A is less than equal to, suppose B C belongs to R, implies that B is less than equal to C. Now for the set of real numbers, we know when A is less than B, B is less than C, then definitely A is less than C, which implies that A C belongs to R. ये बात हम पहले ही कह चुके हैं, वाइस वर्सा चलता है कि अगर A is less than B है तो A भी belongs to R, और अगर A भी belongs to R है तो A less than equal to B. A C belongs to R का मतलब क्या हो गया? R is transitive. So we see that in this relation, relation is reflexive. Relation is transitive, but it is not symmetric. So we conclude that R is not an equivalence relation. Another example, another question in from the first exercise of your NCERT textbook. Let A be the set of all human beings in a time at a particular time. सारे ह्यूमन बीइंग्स का सेट है किसी टर्म का, देयर इज ए रिलेशन आर इक्वल टू एक्स वाई सच दैट एक्स इज फादर ऑफ वाई, मीन्स दोज ऑर्डर्ड पेयर्स आर द पार्ट ऑफ रिलेशन इन विच फर्स्ट एलिमेंट इज फादर ऑफ सेकेंड. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ आई टेक द फैमिली ऑफ, सपोज फैमिली ऑफ किंग दशरथ, देन देयर आर मेंबर्स लाइक दशरथ, सुमित्रा, कैकेयी, कौशल्या, राम, लक्ष्मण, भरत, शत्रुघ्न, सीता एटसेट्रा. इफ वी फॉर्म द ऑर्डर्ड पेयर देन देयर विल बी राम राम, दशरथ दशरथ, राम भरत, राम दशरथ, राम सीता, लाइक दिस ऑर्डर्ड पेयर्स विल बी देयर. When this, I am talking about this relation R equal to x, y such that x is father of y. It means those elements will be part in which first is father of second. Means Dasrath Ram will be the set part of this relation. Ram Dasrath cannot be part of this relation because Ram is not father of Dasrath. Dasrath is father of Ram. Similarly, Love Ram cannot be part of this relation, but Ram Love will be the part of the relation because Ram is father of Love. So first element is father of second, that ordered pair is the part of this relation. AK does not belong to R, as we know that A is not father of A. It implies that R is not reflexive. Let A B belongs to R implies that A is father of B. Now when A is father of B, can we conclude that B is father of A? But B is not father of A. When B is not father of A, it means BA does not belong to R. So R is not symmetric. Let AB belongs to R implies that A is father of B. B C belongs to R implies that B is father of C. Now on this basis, can we conclude that A is father of C? No. But A is not father of C, which implies that A C does not belong to R. So R is not transitive. So we see that this relation is neither reflexive nor symmetric nor transitive. Transitive को एक बार और फिर से सुन लें. A B belongs to R. Suppose we have taken AB belongs to R. It means A is father of B. BC, another ordered pair, belongs to R. It means B is father of C. But A is not father of C. So AC does not belong to R. It means R is not transitive. एक इसमें example लेके भी हम बता सकते हैं. दशरथ राम belongs to R. But राम दशरथ does not belong to R. Similarly, in this we can take example, Dasrath Ram belongs to R, Ram Love belongs to R, but Dasrath Love does not belong to R, so it is not transitive. These are the cases which are not an equivalence relation. Next video में इसके बाद और एक दो example हम लेंगे, दो questions जो reflexive, symmetric, transitive होंगे.